imagine that an ongoing application developed in PHP, which is working with MySQL, your client, due to some reason, wants to migrate from MySQL to some other database or from some other database to MySQL. So in that case, what would you do? Well, if your PHP is working with PDO, that is PHP data object, in that case, there is nothing to worry because PDO will be used as an intermediate connector between the PHP and the backend, and PDO will be configuring the respective database driver and simply will perform rest of the transaction. In keeping this in mind, from today onward, I'm starting a new series involving PHP, PDO, and MySQL, where I will be showing you a mini project that how you can make use of all these three things together. So today being the first presentation, I will show you how you can make use of PDO for setting up your database connectivity. So let's get started. For the very first thing, what you need is, you need to have an IDE, and I'm using the PHP Storm as a PHP IDE, and I will be creating a new project over here. Once I click the button, it will ask you for the project name. Do remember that in your system, the XAMPP must be installed, so your project will be getting stored within the htdocs folder. So let me just type down the name of the project. Let the project be grooming system. So this is the project name I am giving. And once I press the OK button, the project gets generated. And you can see over here, the project name popped up, which has been stored in the specific XAMPP directory of htdoc. Now you need to provide a PHP file over here. And for that, I will simply right click on the project name, go to the new, and over here I will be getting the option called PHP file. So let me click this particular file. It will prompt me to enter a name. So I'm writing the name as db underscore connection because this is the file which I will be using for setting up connection. And this particular file I will be associating in the form of an include once in all other PHP pages. Okay. So for this, let me just type down the respective piece of code which I need to do so. In order to save time, I've already written this piece of code. I'm simply copying that segment. Don't worry, I will explain all the statement over here and I paste it over here. Now, before I start explaining about these statements, there are a few things which I need to do. That is, I need to create the database because until and unless you have a database, the configuration will not be of any use. So let's get to the browser, and I am using the XAMPP for MySQL connectivity, which has already been implemented over here. Let me just show you once. It's already running. This is Apache web server and this is the MySQL, which is already going on. So you also need to implement them. Now you come to the database section. You create a database over here. So let me create a database over here by the name called db underscore grooming. So this is the name of the database which I'm grooming over here, and I press the create button. So once I've created the database over here, for the time being, there is no need for me to generate any table because I just want to show you the connectivity. So in my next video, I'll be talking about the table segment. So let me now just get into the coding part of the PDO. And here onward, the thing will be very important. So what the thing is all about? First and foremost thing, since it is PDO, PHP data object, one thing got very clear that we will be invoking OOPS concept over here. And once you get into OOPS, the concept of try catch will be implemented, and this is very handy. So let me explain line by line what the thing is. The first is the set of variables which you need to declare. And we all know that in PHP, we make use of the dollar sign for declaring the variable. This is the local host, that means the machine in which your MySQL is located. It can be 127.0.0.1. The name of the database you need to mention over here. Just now we create the database, that is db underscore grooming. I will simply write down the name over here, db underscore grooming. And I will show you something very interesting. Let me explain the full thing first. These are the two credentials which you need to provide. Once you load your XAMPP, you get a MySQL install and it comes with the default username as a root and it has got no password, let it be empty. I can create my reference variable. So this is a reference variable and this initialization taking place with the help of the new keyword. As we all know that in any OOPS, we will be invoking new while you are creating, we are actually referencing a reference variable. And PDO over here is working as a constructor. So in this constructor, there are certain parameters we are passing. The first is a string parameter which we are passing. And over here, there are four things that has been mentioned. Let me explain one by one. The first parameter which has been written as MySQL is actually referred as the specific driver This is where PDO becomes so attractive. The moment your client wants to migrate to some other database, immediately you can change the driver name over here. Suppose your client wants to switch over to SQLite, you can simply write SQLite over here. And depending upon your driver, the name of the particular parameter will get changed. The colon followed by the host name, the machine in which your database is located, and the next parameter goes is your database name, which I've already initialized over here. It will be associated over here. So the set of parameter, first parameter comes to an end. Second part is the credential which is there for MySQL that is given. The third parameter which I'm passing over here is basically optional. What this parameter is going to do is, in some cases, suppose your application is not accessing the database for some span of time, then what MySQL will do is that it will disconnect the connection and it will resume once again when a new request has been provided from the client side to the server side. But if you want that the connection should be always active, then you can provide this set of parameter. Else, no issue, each time you request, put the request, the server will accept it and the connection will get formed. So this is an optional part. This much information is sufficient to create or initialize your reference variable. Once the reference variable is initialized, this part is very important. Here you are setting up your error mode. What actually you are going to do is, you want to provide a proper information to the user that if there is any kind of mishandling or any kind of issue popping up while connecting the database, a proper message should be displayed to the end user and the end user should be able to understand. For that reason, you are activating the error mode and you are also generating exception part over here. So this thing you will be invoking with the help of the reference variable which you got created over here, making use of this arrow operator. Do remember, this arrow operator is very similar to that of what we have done in C. If you remember that if you create a structure type pointer variable, then the structure type pointer variable, in order to access any of its member or member method, we used to use this arrow operator and the same logic over here. So the reference variable is giving a call to the member method and these are the following parameter that will be used over there. Okay, and this is very much to the represent to the scope resolution operator in C++. So a lot of things are very common over here in context to OOPs. Now this part will be working fine in case if your database is able to is been correctly mentioned and your application is able to reach the database. But in case if there is any kind of transmission issues, then it will not execute the try block, then it will come to the catch block, and then it will just display this particular message and it will tell you that the database what you are trying to connect is not been able to access. Okay, so let me run this particular page so that will give you an idea about what I'm referring to. As I click my browser button, initially you will get to see this particular statement because my ID is not actually been configured with the PHP. So let me just configure the PHP first. And here you need to just mention the which particular driver or which particular version you're using. And for that, you have to just show the path. You have to show the PHPXA file and it will just configure the version over here. So it's done. This is you need to do it the first time if you activate it, and then the particular interpreter will be recognized and no issue will popped up. Now you can click the browser button and this time it will give you the proper message. See, right now this message is not over here. I mean to say no message is over here. It means that the configuration has been successfully formed. What if I intentionally do some kind of mistake? For example, I am making a spelling mistake over here. Suppose I change the word grooming with double G over here, which is actually not there in the database. And now I try to connect to the application. And this time you are supposed to get a message that the following database which you're trying to access is not available. So this particular message will be there if your try catch block is actually implemented. And this is where the PDO is very handy, because with the help of object-oriented programming, you can make use of this kind of error handling or exceptional part you can make use of. Now, once this connection has been established, you are ready to set go for the next phase of action. That is, I will be using this particular file as a reference to my next page, where I will be adding it in the form of an hash include once, and I will be showing you that in my next video. And that means this particular file will be used in each of the pages where you will be able to connect the database. So in this particular video, I showed you that how the PDO can be configured and how exactly the PDO try catch block is being used for handling all kind of error issues. So let's wait for the next video where I will be talking about the first time, I will be creating a table and I will be trying to configure the table and I will try to put the value directly from that particular page via this particular page, and then finally it will reach to MySQL. So let's meet in my next video. Until then, have a nice time.